Hey there, Bruins fans. Welcome back to BNG Hockey, where it's always black and gold. The Boston Bruins win 4-3 over the Florida Panthers, and it only took them 40 seconds. With this win, the Bruins jump up to second place in the league with a total of 91 points and make it 18 straight games with points. This game didn't start off great for the Bruins. The first period was a lot of back and forth chances. We go all the way to the second to see our first goal. It's a Panthers power play, shot by Keith Yandle, tipped in front by the captain, Barkov, who gets his 29th of the year to put the Panthers up 1-0. And actually, Keith Yandle grabs a point on this. That's his 32nd power play point. Keith Yandle is right up there with the Tory Krugs in running a power play. Not long after, we see a goal from Jonathan Huberdeau. It's his 19th of the year. This is also on the power play. It's not looking good for Boston, as now they're down 2-0. But there's no need to fear. David Krejci is here. Him and Heinen play a little bit of catch back and forth. Krejci roofs it. It's his 17th goal of the season, and now they're only down by one. Now we move on to the third period. This was a great period for Boston. Patrice Bergeron starts it off with another shorthanded goal. That is his third this season. Him and Marchand are just deadly on the penalty kill. McAvoy actually jumps into the play on this one, makes a great play there. It's Bergeron's 24th goal of the season, and now it's tied up 2-2. Panthers aren't done yet, though. Jonathan Huberdeau scores his 20th goal of the season, second of the game, spinning around Zdeno Chara like he's a traffic cone. Z was really bad on this goal. He's right there. Just give Huberdeau a little shove, little nudge, get in his way just a little bit more, and he doesn't even have a chance of getting a shot on net in this one. I blame this one all on Z. Panthers are up 3-2. Under 40 seconds to go. It's a Boston power play. Matt Grzelcyk takes a shot. It is an absolute rocket. It blows past Roberto Luongo to tie it up 3-3. The crowd's going insane. They came all the way back. They were down 2-0. Now it's all tied up. Less than 40 seconds to go. Looks like we're headed to overtime. Bergeron said fans got to catch that early train home. Scores his 25th goal of the season, second of the game, with only 6 seconds to go. The Boston Bruins win with a final of 4-3. What a game. And when you think of clutch, you think of Patrice Bergeron. David Backes was asked afterwards, and he said, if you're going to start a team, you better be picking Bergeron as your best player, because he'd love to see who you pick over him. Bergie is so clutch when it comes to this time. He's done this so many times for the Bruins. Roberto Luongo must have nightmares about Patrice Bergeron. This team loses Marcus Johansson and Jake DeBrusk. Neither played in this game. They do get Sean Corrali back, but they just keep on chugging along. This team's battled through injuries the entire season, and they're fine with everyone stepping up, playing their role, playing when they can, playing in different spots, and they just keep winning. I don't think this team's ever going to lose. That's all I got for you in this one. If you enjoyed today's video, make sure to give it a big like, and if you haven't already, subscribe.